Senate President pro tempore Jinggoy Estrada expresses alarm over China's rising aggressiveness in the West Philippine Sea. Estrada, who is also chair of the Senate panel on national defense, says China's bullying is getting worse following the seizure of humanitarian supplies for the BRP Sierra Madre, the country's low Navy outpost in the area. Estrada calls the incident an affront to humanity and a callous act. The senator also says he supports the filing of another case against China to protest Beijing's belligerent actions in Philippine waters. Makati City prosecutors find probable cause to press murder charges against the suspect in a road rage shooting at the EDSA Ayala Tunnel last week. According to PNP spokesperson Colonel Gene Fajardo, the fiscal cited testimonies from eyewitnesses of the incident. She adds the PNP Firearms and Explosives Office plans to revoke the suspect's firearm license and registration. Last week, the suspect shot dead the driver of a white MPV after their vehicles nearly collided. The victim was a 65-year-old family driver. Commuters will have to brace for another transport strike as Jeepney Group Manibela protests the looming arrest of unconsolidated jeepney drivers. Manibela President Mar Valbuena says the transport holiday will be held on June 10 to 12. He also argues the apprehensions are illegal since they still have valid franchises from Congress. Valbuena adds the strike is a reminder to transport regulators that they already agreed on a one-year extension allowing them to operate and register their units. According to Valbuena, nearly 12,000 jeepney units are unconsolidated in Metro Manila alone. Philippine health authorities report a continued rise in coronavirus cases in the country. The health department said Tuesday it tallied 319 COVID cases on the third week of May, higher from the 202 the week before that. Severe and critical cases make up 10% of hospital admissions. But the agency says all Philippine regions remain at low risk for COVID-19. It adds the voluntary use of face masks and adherence to standard precautions should be done properly. Authorities are also keeping a close watch on four COVID variants, two of which are from the informally known flirt variant. Vote counting still underway following India's mammoth six-week general elections. Prime Minister Narendra Modi's Bharatiya Janata Party is leading the vote count, but it is unlikely to win an overwhelming majority, as predicted by exit polls. Over 640 million votes were cast to elect 543 members of the Indian Parliament's lower house. Modi is targeting to clinch 400 of them. Final results are expected by the end of the day. Flooding caused by torrential rains leave at least 12 dead on South Africa's eastern coast. More than 2,000 people have been evacuated from Nelson Mandela Bay in eastern Cape Province. A state of alert has been declared in neighboring KwaZulu-Natal province. The country's weather agency says South Africa is in the grip of a weather system marked by heavy rains and a cold snap that can also bring hail, snow, and strong winds. In Hawaii, the Kilauea volcano has erupted. The volcano, which is one of the most active in the world, began expelling lava and smoke early Monday and ceased 12 hours later. The eruption is confined to a remote area within the national park and did not pose an immediate threat. Authorities said elevated volcanic gas emissions continue, and it's possible the eruption could resume.